What's up guys, this is Yosh and welcome to this fresh video. And in today's video, I wanted to actually go over a few things, and one problem that I come across a lot of times, and a lot of my clients kind of have this problem, and I think addressing that in this particular video would help a lot. So the problem that we're discussing today is, you're starting to get traffic to your story, you're getting traffic to your story, getting traffic to your website, but as soon as you cut down your Facebook ads, the traffic dies, right? So you're getting tons of traffic, it stops as soon as your Facebook ads die, and how do you address that? And how do you keep getting continuous traffic to your website even after you stop your ads? We're gonna talk about that today. Okay, so first step first. When you run a Facebook ad, what are you really doing? You put out an ad and you're paying money to get impressions. You're paying money, you're sending out your ad, you're trying to show your ad to different people. So you start getting some views and start getting some traction. Traction meaning getting clicks to your website. So it's simple. You put out an ad, someone looks at it, it's a clickbait, it's a nice ad, it has value, it has a great graphic, whatever it is, you're getting a click. Now what do you do with that click? How do you actually make value out of that? Obviously, if someone came to your website and then just visited the website and left, it's not gonna really do anything about it. So I'm gonna give you three tips how you could get that traffic to come back to you and how you could stop paying your money to ads and still get traffic later from the same kind of people. So step number one. Step number one is pretty simple. Everybody tells you, collect your freaking email IDs. Make sure you're collecting email IDs. If you get someone onto your website, give them an amazing offer that they cannot put down. Number one, give them like a 15%, a 20% off, or 10% off, or huge value. Like, give them a complimentary product free. So say if someone is coming in to buy shoes, give them shoe polish free. I know no one uses shoe polish. Okay, no one uses shoe polish. Someone comes in to go buy one watch, give them a free strap if they order today. With that, if you're giving them a high value offer, they're more likely to actually put in their email ID, which you could really use later and send out a newsletter or a specific segmented email. We're gonna talk about newsletters in our next video. Second, point number two, the second thing that you could really do in order to get more clients to come right into your store, even after you stop actually putting out Facebook ads or Instagram ads or Pinterest ads, is to use a subscription kind of service that they subscribe to so you could send out messages. So now, right now what you're looking at the screen is one of the plugins that you could really use and put it on your own website. And whoever comes to your website actually clicks on this and subscribes to get these notifications right from your store, right from your website, when you post something new, when a new product comes in, or if you just wanna push out a message. This way you could get tons and tons of more traffic coming to you, because when they came onto the website, they're highly likely to click allow to just go to the next page. Even if you get 10% of the people hitting allow and actually subscribing to that notification bar, what you're really doing is that all out of 100 people, 10%, at least you will get that 10% of the traffic to come back to you by itself. This is gonna be amazing. Make sure when you do that, give them something of high value. Make it very, very transparent so they're not unsubscribing later. Make sure you're not bombarding people with these subscription messages to get in the traffic, because you have to realize it's one person seeing that message repeatedly, they're more likely to unsubscribe from this subscription that they've done, or a little subscribe button, or this little button that they've allowed you to notify them. Don't over bombard them with notifications. Keep it to a minimal, but make sure those notifications have great value. Point number three. Run offer ads on Facebook. What do I mean by offer ads? So if you go into Facebook, you could see there's an option to run offer ads. Offer ads is similar like feed ads, are similar to video ads, similar to any kind of ads. But when you do an offer ad, in order for someone to get that offer, what they do, they click on a button and they actually accept the offer, or they get the offer, the coupon code, or whatever offer that you're giving, free shipping with a code, 10% off with the code, 20% off with the code, whatever. So let's assume you're running an ad and it has an offer of 10% off if you click on it right now. They click on it, they get the offer, but the offer doesn't expire. Today, say, is October the 2nd, offer expires on the October the 10th. So you have 8 days in the middle. What Facebook would automatically do after, say you run this ad for 3 days from October 2nd to the October 5th, the rest of the time you don't run this ad. So the 5 days in the middle, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th, you don't run any ads, right? You stop running those ads. But what Facebook's gonna start doing is whoever kind of took up the offer in the first days, they're gonna send them a notification via email and via Facebook notification bell on the top, telling them that their offer that they actually accepted to is going to expire soon. Now that is free retargeting that you got through Facebook offer ads. This is a golden nugget that you could really use into getting more traffic coming back to your website just by using offer ads. So a quick recap. So you keep getting traffic even after you stop your Facebook ads. Number one, send them to your website and make sure to collect their email IDs. Don't bug them, give them a great offer so you have the email ID. Number two, set up a subscription service or a notification bar service. Examples are in the description. You go there or you could just simply subscribe. They're not affiliate links. You go ahead and get that, put it on your website and start sending out notifications through their browser. Number three, run offer ads because that would help you get the free retargeting through Facebook email and Facebook notifications that you do not even have to program. Facebook does that for you. So that's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, go ahead down there and hit the like button because that helps so much. And the family's been growing here. I've just hit 1,000-some subscribers now, so I'm super-duper happy. I know it took a long time to get there. I'm not being very, very constant with posting videos. That is gonna change because that's the new commitment for this new quarter. And for some great tips, tricks, and all this good e-commerce marketing, online digital marketing kind of stuff, subscribe to my channel because I like to keep posting that information and send out information to people who subscribe, go to my website, do my stuff. So go to the comment section, tell me if you have any more tips, tricks, and other things to share. Thank you so much for watching this video. Click right here to watch my other video. Click right here to watch one of my previous videos. Thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe. Take care, peace, keep grinding.